What do you see right now that both intrigues you as well as worries you about the direction of aviation?
I think my greatest concern, no longer having to be the upbeat spokesperson for general aviation, is I'm really concerned now about the infrastructure. And by that I just don't mean my pet peeve, the pilot population. Of course, that's a big one, dipped below 600,000 now, continues to go down. I beat my head against the wall for almost two decades, spent lots and lots of member money, got other friends in the industry to spend their money, and we still haven't found the solution, other than just going out right and buying pilot license for people, on how to fix that. But the other things, our airports, I don't think are going to continue getting the funding that they have in the past. They're now talking about looking at how robust an airport is for GA and determining the number of based aircraft, and then maybe allocating funds in a different way. When you look at some of the other things attached, security, tightening all the time, the infrastructure really bothers me. And it's all a function of being a pretty small special interest group as we continue to shrink in size.
We know where we are right now, and it's not been the best of times and such. What do you say to an industry that's seen better days, a bit down on its luck, about what the future might bring and how we can craft that to a more positive direction?
Well, and I think it you see it happening. Everybody in the industry has got to be looking over their shoulder, in front of them, around to the side of them, at any kinds of things that could come down from regulatory agencies, from Congress, from local communities, and work in any concerted, in a very concerted and targeted way to make sure that as we come out of this economic situation that's caused the doldrums for a lot of the sales, that we aren't left, as I say, with an infrastructure that's hard to work with itself. So I've seen, for instance, the Manufacturers Association in our backyard held a couple weeks ago, and Ohio bringing in the local and the federal Congress and congressional people and showing them how much aviation business activity there is in Ohio. But we have to keep doing that, because we will come out of this. I'm optimistic of that. But let's not come out with higher security rules, higher costs out of the FAA, whether it be onerous user fees to charges for medicals, I think are in the current bill that everybody's waiting to get signed. Not a charge at your AME you should pay now, but a charge just for them to issue the certificate. And we've seen what's happening on the registration. So we've all got to be really on our toes to look at the little things and, oh, well, that isn't that much. But pretty soon it mounts up. And as a guy now on a fixed income, I can really speak to, gee, I want to be able to continue to enjoy flying my planes as best I can without this crippling cost.
Aero TV is brought to you by...
Now, another moment of freedom from Cirrus Aircraft. Freedom through safety. Perhaps the ultimate freedom is confidence, assurance, and peace of mind. We design it into every personal aircraft we build. It's the security that comes with knowing you're flying the plane with a parachute. The breakthrough concept that launched the Cirrus phenomenon.